Dual PC workflows are a huge part of most of the top-tier streamers' setups. While computer hardware has evolved to make single PC streaming possible on a more casual level, you really can't beat the flexibility of a dual setup, especially when that means that there is no performance impact on the games you are playing. The problem is, gaming setups have moved away from 1080p 60 being the high end, and now 1440p, 4K, and 120 or 140Hz monitors are becoming much more common to game on. In older versions of Windows, even pre-Fall Creators Update Windows 10, you could force clone a high refresh or a high resolution, but not both, video feed to a 1080p 60 capture card, but you'd get nasty screen tearing if you were on the high refresh side of things and weird scaling artifacts on the high resolution. Using something like NDI is neat for a lot of things, but even on my high-end rig, just having OBS open on the gaming rig at all can cause framerate issues. There are lots of other workarounds out there, but they all involve sacrificing some sort of compatibility or introducing some kind of tearing, jitter, or other issues. I'm Evil's Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, today showing you my guide for using the Elgato 4K 60 Pro for dual PC high refresh rate streaming setups. Previously, capture cards that supported such a setup were too expensive, too at over $800, just not really accessible. But the Elgato 4K 60 Pro at just $400, which may seem expensive compared to the 1080p capture cards, but it's actually quite affordable for the 4K capture market, as I explain in my review here, has come along and really changed the market, and it supports not only 4K 60fps, but 1080p up to 240Hz and 1440p up to 144Hz as well. That's why they sponsored this video, so I can show you how to use their new capture card to stream and record 1440p 144Hz, or whichever high resolution refresh rate combo you enjoy within a dual PC setup. We'll be covering two methods: cloning your non-HDMI monitor setup to the 4K 60 Pro, for those with monitors that don't have HDMI 2.0 and are hooked up via DisplayPort or DVI, and then using the 4K 60 Pro's HDMI 2.0 pass-through for a HDMI 2.0 capable monitor to just run a straight chain. I'll also briefly show how to add the 4K 60 Pro to OBS Studio or your favorite software. For this, we'll be using the BenQ Zowie XL2730, a 27-inch 1440p 144Hz monitor made for fast-paced gaming. These settings will be focused on 1440p 144Hz for this monitor, but of course you can simply adjust to your desired setup specs. Big note, make sure you're using an HDMI 2.0 18 gigabit per second compatible cables. Your old HDMI cables for your Xbox 360 or older 1080p days will not work for high resolutions and refresh rates. You need one of the newer cables. The Elgato 4K 60 Pro does come with a small HDMI 2.0 cable for running from your graphics card. We'll start with the more common setup. Your main monitor is connected to your gaming PC via DisplayPort or maybe DVI. To use the 4K 60 Pro, start by running the HDMI output from your PC's graphics card to the 4K 60 Pro. If you're already using the dedicated HDMI output of your graphics card, you can use a DisplayPort to HDMI adapter, but you need to make sure it's a DisplayPort 1.4 or newer to HDMI 2.0 or newer adapter, which are going to be less common, or you won't be able to push the signal correctly. Honestly, it would be smarter to use said adapter for your secondary monitor or whatever else you're using that HDMI port for now, and just use the dedicated HDMI to run to the 4K 60 Pro, just to eliminate possible points of incompatibility. On your streaming rig, run the Elgato 4K Capture Utility. Click the settings cog in the top right, change input EDID mode to internal, and change EDID to 1440p. Back on your gaming rig, open up the Windows 10 display settings, or your graphics card control panel if you prefer that. Change the settings to clone your main monitor and the 4K 60 output together. Click where it says multiple displays and choose duplicate desktop on blank and blank, depending on your setup. If you just have one monitor hooked up to your gaming rig, it would be 1 and 2. Hit apply and let it do its thing. Now open up your graphics driver control panel, go to display options, and confirm that your output is set to 1440p and 144Hz. You may need to manually set this again because it might default to 60Hz, but it should work once you manually apply it. Finally, check your 4K capture utility settings and confirm that the video input signal is 1440p 144Hz as well. If you have an HDMI 2.0 capable monitor, this setup actually is a lot easier. This works much like a console to capture card setup would. Simply run an HDMI cable from your graphics card to the Elgato 4K 60 Pro's input, and another from the 4K 60 Pro's output to your monitor. Check your Windows 10 display settings or graphics card control panel and make sure your resolution and refresh rate are set correctly to 1440p 144Hz in our case. Open the Elgato 4K capture utility and verify that the input signal is set correctly as well. You can set input EDID mode to display for generally the best results here. Then you're good to go, ready to capture and stream in beautiful, smooth 1440p 144Hz. Next, let's cover how to add the 4K 60 Pro to OBS Studio. Similar principles can be applied to pretty much any streaming software that you prefer. With OBS open and the 4K capture utility closed, on your streaming rig, add a new video capture device. Choose the Game Capture 4K 60 Pro Video 01 device. For settings, use what you see on screen now. Resolution set to custom at 2560 by 1440, frame rate set to highest, format YV12, color range and color space set to default, buffering disabled. Set your output audio mode as needed, stream only is the default and should work fine for most. Check to use custom audio device and choose Game Capture 4K 60 Pro Audio 01. Choose that device. You may need to scale your video source to your canvas depending on the rest of your settings within your streaming software. And voila, 2PC 1440p 144Hz setup with no lag, tearing, jittering, or framerate impact on the gaming PC. And you're ready to go. Start streaming. If you enjoyed this guide, hit the like button and subscribe for more awesome tech content. Affiliate product links for the Elgato 4K 60 Pro will be in the description down below. Down there is a link to my Twitch where you can follow to watch me stream the rare times that I do so. I need to get back to that. Hi, Meeples Box. I'll see you next time. This video is sponsored by viewers like you. Our videos would not be possible without the generosity of those of you who contribute to one of our fan funding options, be it Donor Box, Twitch subscriptions, direct contributions via PayPal, or Patreon. To join our inner circle and get behind-the-scenes looks at videos, go to eposvox.com/support to learn more, and join us on Discord at eposvox.com/discord. Thanks!